I'm Rebecca M. Carroll, and I am with
Jessica Pauley. I'm second lieutenant in the Idaho Army National Guard.
So second lieutenant means that you are actually a commissioned officer.
Yes, ma'am.
So that means that you have a path that you took advantage of, and we want to know about it because I know that you had a scholarship. I know that you weren't in the ROTC program immediately, and I think this is all great stuff for kids to understand. So the biggest question that I always get asked is, can I pay for school with the GI Bill?
Well, I think that is yes and no, because I used my GI Bill. I was able to come in on scholarship through the Idaho National Guard. It was a guaranteed reserve federal scholarship, and that helped me pay for the last 2 years of my college degree. And I was able to keep my GI Bill that I'd earned by going to basic training and AIT. You have to qualify for a GI Bill by going to a certain amount of training as an enlisted soldier. And when you can keep that, it's beneficial because you would give that up normally if you were taking a four-year scholarship with the Guard.
So you had no intention of going with anything to do with the military when you went off to college?
Not originally, no.
So what changed your mind?
I think it was simply being a freshman and not really knowing what my path was going to be further down the line and feeling a little bit confused about what I wanted to study and if I was really that invested in being a pre-med and then I have to go to med school and do I even like the courses I'm taking? So a lot of it for me was just needing a little bit of time. And you can't just, I don't know, I guess you can't just live off your parents for the rest of your life.
So no, you can't.
You have to buy time, right? Yeah. So I bought that time with the Guard.
So how did you initially get introduced to it?
I had some friends who were in the Guard, and they did really well, and they had full-time jobs in the Guard, and they got to go to really cool trainings and do some really fun things that kind of piqued my interest. And when I looked into it a little bit more, I realized that the Army was so much more than just what it's painted to be a lot of times in movies and films and other things where you think it's just going to be a bunch of guys walking around with weapons all the time and like doing all this hoo-hoo stuff. And some of that is really fun, but it has this whole other side too where they have professional development and you can build skills. So when I enlisted, I came in as a public affairs specialist, and I was able to learn how to write and take photography courses and kind of build an idea of what my future could be that was completely unrelated to biology. And I would never...
Which was your first major.
My first major, exactly.
Oh, okay.
And I never would have discovered that had I not been in the National Guard.
Well, you definitely have a talent for speaking because you ended up getting a nice scholarship your freshman or every year because of your speech and debate. How did that work?
I did a speech and debate when I was in high school all 4 years, and I loved it. It was great for me. I thought it also developed a lot of skills that people don't otherwise have when they freshly come out of high school. So I was able to get a partial scholarship at the Boise State Talkin' Broncos speech and debate team. And we went on to be national champions.
I know. I'm so excited to have one of you because that was huge. You were up against, tell the schools you were up against.
It was huge schools that have dominated speech and debate. And mm-hmm. It's the Pi Kappa Delta is the national, it's like the organization that hosts the nationals, and there's hundreds and hundreds of different schools and different people competing in all different events. And at the time we were transitioning between coaches, but the one who came in, the first coach we had, he was able to get us through to nationals. And I think when Amanda Hicks took over, who's the current coach, she just made the team go even further and just bettered it, made us more cohesive. And
so you get through to nationals, which is quite an accomplishment. So you must have been feeling like you can do things.
Sure. Yeah, I think being on the speech and debate team did help build my confidence. You also get that fellowship kind of from being with other speech and debate members, mm-hmm. and you build friendships and people who are really motivated for their future. They kind of know what they're doing. But I didn't feel like that. So I saw all the success and people who are so sure of their career paths, and I wasn't feeling that same way. So I think I needed to have a little bit of time to think about it, whether or not it was actually for me.
So you end up around sophomore year joining, enlisting?
Yes. So I decided I needed to take some time off of school. So I ended up dropping, leaving the speech and debate team, foregoing my scholarship.
Okay.
Which was the hardest part, I think. But then I looked into the National Guard a little bit more. And after taking some college courses at CWI and just trying to find out what I was actually interested in studying,
yeah.
I did end up enlisting, yes, in 2014.
So by enlisting, that means you go to a boot camp.
Yes.
So how'd you like that?
It wasn't bad. I went down to Fort Jackson for basic training.
Okay.
And that's 10 weeks. And then I followed that up with Fort Meade in Maryland. And I was studying at the time public affairs. That was really great. That was also 10 mm-hmm. or so weeks, 10 to 13. So I was gone for a total of 6 months, and then I came back. And it's weird that you think everything's going to be different, but nothing was. You come back from training, and it's only been 6 months, and your friends are still your friends, and they still hang out with you the way, like, everything just kind of keeps moving, but in a weird way, it stays the same.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I have several students who have done it that way, where they've taken a semester off. If they can get to boot camp soon enough, they only have to take one semester off because it might have been incorporated in their summer, and then they're ready to roll either in spring, or it's the vice versa where they get to boot camp in the spring semester and then by fall. And it's helpful. So the question would be, and I know it's different for everybody because not everybody understands the logistics of a GI Bill, or they don't realize that there are other opportunities. So you're enlisted, you go to boot camp, you get through that, you come back. Did you change your major?
I did, yes. So I ended up studying public affairs at Fort Meade, like I said, and that was the most exciting thing I had done in my life so far. Was able to learn about cameras and writing, and I got new skills in my repertoire, and I could add that to my resume, and I was really, really interested in pursuing that at the time. So I ended up coming back, changing my major to media arts, but then wondering, okay, how do I pay for the rest of my school, and what am I going to do? I knew that I had my GI Bill, but if I draw that every month, it's going to be a stipend, and it's not going to quite pay for my full tuition.
Okay.
But because I had the GRFD, I looked into it, and I was able to contract National Guard to commission as an officer. And if I did that, I would get a 2-year scholarship to pay for my full tuition. I would get a stipend, and I would get my drill pay and a book stipend each month or every semester. And then I would also be able to keep my GI Bill. So all of that, I was making about $2,000 a month just to go to school. And
that
helped me out a lot.
Helpful.
Yes.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of stress off. I could just focus on school. I didn't have to work a part-time job or anything like that. Some of my peers did. You know, they're working at coffee shops and things, and I was able to just focus on school, do my drill every month, and be in the Guard, and kind of look forward to the next thing I was doing.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. So you graduated.
I did. Graduated in May of 2018, and I commissioned the same day.
And so what has life been? What has life been? And, I mean, number one, you don't have a lot of debt from college.
I have no debt from college.
No debt from college.
None at all. No, it's been great. And then also as a fresh lieutenant, there are some programs you can take advantage of to get loans. It's called like a first step or like new commissioning loans that you can take. That helps me pay for my car too. So I was able to just pay my car off and like not have any interest rates building up on that. And so a lot of really good opportunities to give you the best first step you can coming out of college, so you're not overwhelmed with debt, wondering what you're going to do next. And once I got a job, full-time orders for the National Guard, that helped me out as well, because you're just networking and you're trying to figure out the next training opportunity, and you're getting that military experience, which I think is key, because that's why people join the military. They like doing those things, and yeah. I like doing those things, and It's been really fun getting an opportunity to do that side too.
Yeah, I have had so many people wherever I have lived who have been involved in the military. My son's involved in the military. He's in the reserves, Navy. And it's been wonderful. There's just been so many opportunities. If you're ready to buy a house, there's just loans, the loans and the low interest. And yeah, it's good. And I feel like wherever you apply, there's people are really willing to hire military personnel because you've been trained in a different way. So
I do find that that is true, yes.
Yeah.
And people have been really supportive as of late, too, of just the military in general. So you get that positive attitude and from everyone that you meet. And since graduating, it's been going to really fun trainings. I just recently finished infantry training, and I'm really excited to use that training towards my new unit placement right now. We'll be doing really fun international things, like going to Germany in a couple months.
And that's wonderful.
Yeah, I've been able to go to Romania with the National Guard in 2016. We send people to all kinds of international that you've never experienced before. And you're new out of high school or you're just into college. A lot of people haven't had that chance to travel or really see the world. I think there's something really eye-opening about it. And it's very important to a college education to be able to understand what the world is like outside of yourself and outside of your community.
I really believe that. I think it's important. And you're an Idaho young lady.
I graduated from CUNA.
Yeah. So that's a really far distance, you know, being able to travel and do things. And it does it make you understand that you don't always have to be home? I mean, you can come home, but I've always been really open, and I'm glad my kids have had experiences of travel, because I think it really does pull in this idea of that we're not the center of the universe.
No, and yeah, exactly.
There are tons of opportunities. And I think that people can go away for a bit, build their opportunities, and then move back. So do you think you're going to be career forever, or are you looking at that? Or
yeah, I definitely considered it. I think for me, the Guard has been nothing but positive. It's really been kind of like the life-changing decision that I made, you know, a few years ago that I will absolutely not regret at all. And because of the opportunity I've been able to give, I've been given in the Guard, I want to be able to give that back to this organization that's helped me so much. So I think the only way to do that would be to stay in and hopefully get other people excited about staying in, because it takes so much money and time to train a soldier that once they get to that point and they decide they're just going to do like 3 years or 6 years and get out, they've at that point really just not done much for the organization. But being able to give that back, I think, is in itself rewarding.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's good. So if you could say one thing to students, what would you say? Whether they're at college or they're at, because your path is very similar. My son was halfway through his career and thinking he didn't want to do it, which is funny because he's doing what he... criminal justice, but that's why it appealed to him to just kind of pause and take a break,
exactly.
Got into the Navy, got out, and he's working in a criminal justice field, and he has a couple more courses to finish up. But what would you say to people, whether they were in high school or college?
I would say don't be afraid to not know what you want to do immediately. Take that time, whether it be a gap year or finding a part-time job or taking college credits at CWI or just a tiny university where you know you're not going to maybe graduate, but you can at least expand your options, expand your mind, and figure out what you want to do and be really confident in that, because there's no point in making decisions when you really don't know all of your options. And the Guard for me was one of those options I didn't know about immediately.
Mm-hmm.
But because I was able to take time and reflect on what I really wanted to do, I was able to get into it. One of the best decisions I've ever made in my life.
Well, and plus it alleviates the financial stress. So you really now can make decisions without that piece kind of pushing, well, I have to do this. I have to. This is the way I, you know, now
exactly.
you can get into political science and you can look and develop into. There's so many opportunities in the Army and the Army National Guard for political science. I mean, that is a diplomats. There's all kinds of things that you can be doing. So.
And I almost hate to get into that angle, but I think that especially for women, if you can be in an environment that is very male-dominated, like the military, mm-hmm. and you can show that you have those leadership skills and you're able to be competitive in that way, that will also help you later on in, like, career. And I think it's helped me a lot because there's almost an unspoken assumption that just because I am a military and I am an officer, and maybe specifically an infantry officer, that I have the skills that are necessary to be assertive and be a leader, be in management roles, and not have that be second guessed because of my gender.
Yeah.
And that's something I earned also because of the military. Never would have gotten that otherwise.
Yeah. Yeah. And that it's very real. And I think it's a great way for many young women to really develop themselves and understand that they are capable. So great. So we know now that there are ways to get yourself fully funded in by looking at the various opportunities. It may not be just with the GI Bill, but it may be with the GI Bill and other opportunities that you pull in and dance around. So probably, how did you get all this knowledge? Did you go to a specific person? Because I really, Boise State does a fabulous job. They have a wonderful enrollment officer. A lot of my clients, we work together. So who did you tap into?
I think once I got into the program, I did talk to the enrollment officers. I made sure that I went down to that little VA center that's at Boise State.
Oh, so good.
It's very yeah. helpful because you have computers there. I just sat down on a computer there and I was able to log in to the portal I needed to get to mm-hmm. put in my first waiver form so that I would start collecting my GI Bill while I was also getting my stipend and everything else. And once you get that information to the enrollment officer, those just get automatically deposited into your account. So I didn't have to worry about it. I would just get informed, like, hey, by the way, the stipends just came out this month. You guys should be seeing that in your accounts. And, of course, all the ROTC cadets were like, yes, we're getting paid, finally.
Yeah.
So there are a lot of resources and points of contact, I think, that want to be helpful. But you can't be afraid to ask the questions either. I think that's the big thing. So if there's something you don't know, definitely ask, because there's so many opportunities and loopholes, I think, for getting your school paid for. People are just too afraid to ask. They don't even know about it.
Yeah.
And then they end up having to pay or get student loans or something like that when, I mean, it's completely unnecessary. And college is so expensive.
It is.
You take advantage of every opportunity you can to pay for as much as you can of it.
Oh, yeah. So. Oh, absolutely. Yes. Well, great. Thank you so much. And we will have more on the Idaho National Guard. We have a couple more people that will be coming in and talking about their experience because I think it's a great, great way to pay for school.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.